Hey, Gene, how are you?
Nice to see you. Roger.
Hi, Dave.
Nice to see you. You guys saw the Flintstones, right? The movie?
Sure.
Listen to this. I've been working on something. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my first guests, Gene Siskel Stone and Roger Ebert Rock. What do you think?
How the hell did you get a TV show?
From New York, feel free to tip your paramedic if they do a good job. It's The Late Show with David Letterman. Tonight, Siskel and Ebert, musical group Indigo Girls, and actress Andrea Martin. Plus, Paul Schaefer and the CBS Orchestra. And now, a man who always gets in trouble for not rewinding, David Letterman.
Automatic door is not working. That means to me that the QVC merger apparently has gone through. Welcome to the program, ladies and gentlemen. Nice to see you. Guess who I am? I'm Dave. I'm the host. I just want to mention one thing. Maybe you know about this. It's being reported today in the newspapers that CBS, this great television network for which we work, and QVC, which is a home shopping outlet, cable outlet, the possibility of a merger. They're now talking about the merger. Now, let me remind you of something. The merger has not yet gone through. So do me a favor. Quit phoning in here trying to buy my hairpiece, okay? Do you remember the old days when those doors are just whoop, whoop? Now, this is about all we can get. Well, you know. But you know what? Ought to be a pretty good deal, come to think about it. If the QVC merger does go through, it should take the sting out of CBS losing the professional football contract, because I think QVC sells those NFL team glasses. So it'd be nice to get a set of those.
That'll be nice.
You know, something very strange happened here in New York City today. I was reading in the newspaper that Richard Simmons, you folks familiar with Richard Simmons?
Yes.
Apparently, Richard Simmons has gone to Tiffany's and purchased a diamond ring for Barbara Streisand to commemorate their 30-year love affair.
No.
Now, here's where it gets a little wacky. They have never met.
No.
Apparently, someone is not playing with a full deck of De La Mille cards. Well, ladies and gentlemen, what was that? What did I miss there? What happened there? It's the guy's talking over the jokes. Nice to see you. You boys in town for the World Cup?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, sure. Yeah, yeah. You betcha. It's the Goatee Club. Good luck. Julia Roberts' new movie opens today. It's called I Love Trouble. That's the name of the new Julia Roberts summer blockbuster. It opens today. And I believe pretty soon she's going to begin shooting the sequel to that movie, I Love Strange Hair. Oh, that'll be... Very, very odd reaction.
Well. True.
They don't like it, but they don't know why exactly. It's clear it was upsetting, but they're not really sure what about that was. Hey, listen to this. Here's a medical breakthrough. Maybe you'll like this. The folks at Johnson & Johnson Pharmaceuticals have introduced a home cholesterol testing kit. I think this is an invaluable health aid. Here's how this works. You take a little of your own blood and you put it on some treated paper, and if the paper turns pink, cholesterol is fine. Mm-hmm. If the paper turns blue, well, it could be a little high. If you see a picture of Elvis, you put down the bacon and get to a hospital immediately. How about a nice hand for the Hee-Haw Honeys, ladies and gentlemen, right here. Yes, sir. Nice to see you, kids. My best to Buck and Roy. Oh, man. Ladies and gentlemen, here's a sports reminder. Good seats are still available for the next Mets home game. It's Thursday night, July 14th, and you probably want to get out there early because it's Doc Gooden Dealer Appreciation Night. So just get on out there and have a blast. Close them doors. Morty, try, get them doors closed. Can we try and close them doors?
There they go.
Here we go. Yeah! Let me tell you something, Bob. You are a genius. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a wonderful program. Can you feel it? Can you tell that we have a... You bet. We have a... On the show tonight, our old friends Siskel and Ebert are here. That's right.
What's going on over there?
I'm just amusing myself. What if, like, what if I had a gopher in my jacket? Also, thank you, sir. Also, on the program tonight, Indigo Girls. And, a very funny woman and a great actress, an old friend of ours, Andrea Martin, will be joining us this evening, kids. Now, do me a favor. Oh, man, too much pre-show soda. Do me a favor, say hello to our good friend, Mr. Paul Schaefer. He's right over there. Paul! I was thinking about this. I don't know if this means anything to us. You know, when we used to work at NBC, remember that, Paul, years and years and years ago?
Yeah,
Paul,
way back.
If you don't understand this, Paul and I used to do a show over at NBC, similar to this show. And we'd been working there about 5 or 6 years, and suddenly a global corporate giant, General Electric, comes in and buys the network.
I remember
that. Well,
yeah.
That was the beginning of the end for all of us. Ah, yes. Yes, absolutely. Yes. Have you folks ever had light bulbs burn out? Well... It's those bastards at GE. That's what they're doing to you. They're burning out your light bulbs. So anyway, now this thing happens where they're talking about this merger with QVC. It's not really a takeover, I don't think. It's not like they're taking over CBS. And I think CBS will still maintain control of the new organization if it goes through. But it makes you a little unsure of your future with the network.
Of course.
And I, you know, here, of course, is my biggest fear that this QVC, the home shopping thing, it stands for quality.
Right.
Value.
Yes.
And convenience.
I see.
That's right. So, you know, this, I guess, would be our biggest fear, that one night you'll tune in and it's just us selling crap, you know? They put up the little plate and then you get the little stuff there on the screen. There, it's just... have the plates right here. Just to get the whole set. You know, this ain't a bad idea. We could make a fortune on this crap.
How much would those go for?
We could unload these for like $100 a piece.
You think?
Oh, easy.
Simple as that.
Hal, do me a favor. Turn on the external camera, will you? Hal Gurney, our director, ladies and gentlemen. Wow.
Okay.
Looks like it's raining. Looks like we had a cloudburst there because all afternoon it was hot, it was muggy, it was like being in downtown Manila. And let me tell you something, folks. I've never been in downtown Manila, but it was just that hot and muggy, and now it's coming down in buckets. It's coming down in, what do they call that? It's raining dogs.
Sheets. Cats and dogs.
Yeah, raining cats and dogs. Wow. Yes, sir. We thought since it was so steamy and so hot earlier, we'd invite somebody in to cool off. Because outside, it's very, very hot. Inside, it couldn't be more comfortable. Isn't it a lovely temperature inside? We could sell that. We could sell the plates and the thermometer for $150.
All right.
But now, since it's not really all... There you go. That, the whole collection. You get the thermometer and the plates for $150, ladies and gentlemen. But since it's not that hot outside... Turn on that camera again, Hal. Geez, we had a great idea, now it's just gone to hell. This is our first rain out here on the show. You see, it was so hot out there, and it's so cool inside, we're going to invite somebody in, but now it just ain't that hot out there. Ain't that hot in here either, come to think of it. Let's see, Hal, get in there on the phones, and maybe we can invite somebody in here to dry off. Awful lot of activity going on out there. And now that we're getting ready to place the phone call, there is no activity. Oh, well, that guy is soaked. This is the perfect kind of guy. Right there. Stay right there. I'm calling you. Stay right there, buddy. Don't move. Let me get the phone. All right, we'll try and call. I'm going to need a little dialing music here. We'll be calling out there. I bet that guy's from out of town. Doesn't he have that out-of-town look to him? You know, come to think of it, I'm from out of town. Okay, that one's busy. All right. No, no, please, please, don't despair. So what if we bump Siskel and Ebert? Hey. Okay.
Hello?
Yeah.
Hello?
Yes, this is Mayor Giuliani. I'd like to see you in a raincoat.
Well, Mayor Giuliani?
What is your name, sir?
I don't have a little kid with me right now.
What is your name?
My name's Tim Garrison.
Where are you from, Tim?
I'm from Kansas City, Missouri.
What did I say?
Well, ain't no Texas right now.
What are you doing in town, Tim?
What?
I say, what are you doing in town?
Well, I brought my girlfriend to see the Indigo girl.
Uh-huh.
And she had no idea. We got on a plane in Kansas City, had no idea we're going to New York.
Yeah.
And then she had no idea
right
we were walking down to see the Indigo
Tim,
girl.
Tim.
Yeah?
Get a hold of yourself. You're delirious.
I am delirious. I think I've been hypnotized by this rain.
Yeah. Tim, can this story be told in under an hour?
What?
Never mind. Is that your girlfriend right there?
Yeah.
Boy, the two of you look like you're soaked.
We are soaked.
Yeah. Would you like to come in and dry off?
What?
I say, would you like to come in and dry off?
Oh, Dave, I'd love to come in and dry off. Can she come in, too? Is this Dave Lerman?
All right, well... Now, you have to behave yourself, all right?
I promise I will, sir.
All right, well, somebody will show you how to get in, and hurry up. Come on, what's your girlfriend's name?
Okay, Megan.
All right, Megan. Tim and Megan. Come on in, kids. All right, hurry. Boy, look, you guys are soaked. You're soaking wet. Here, come on over here. Siskel and Ebert are here. Here, there's a towel. There's a towel for you. There you go. Now dry off. Are you all dry now?
Well, we bought this umbrella for $5 outside.
Right,
did we get ripped off?
We heard your story, Tim. Why don't you guys go over there and have a seat? You can't really sit there. We have Siskel and Ebert coming. Just go over there and sit
right. Hold on, we're moving critics off.
That's right. Just have a seat, Tim. And for the first time in your life, try to be quiet for a little bit. There you go. Sit down. There we go. It's Tim and Megan from Kansas City. Okay, enjoy those. Well, okay, now we got us a show, more or less, you know. We're going to do a commercial when we come back. Our old friends Siskel and Ebert right there, ladies and gentlemen. Nice to see you. Welcome to the program. That's Tim Garrison and Megan Need from both from Kansas City.
Uh-huh.
What do you guys do? Do you go to school? You work? Do you
both? I go to school.
Where do you go to school?
Park College.
Park College is where?
In Kansas City, Missouri.
Is that one of those tiny little private liberal arts schools? Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it kind of like a diploma factory, or is it a real?
Yeah.
What are you studying there?
Criminal justice.
Criminal justice. Well, you came to the right town, man. That's your work cut out for you here. And are you a sophomore? Are you a junior? What are you?
Junior.
Going to be a junior. Oh, good. Nice to see you. You seem like a very nice woman.
Well,
have you been to New York City before?
I've never been to New York.
It's exciting, isn't it?
Yes, came for the Indigo Girls concert, actually.
Well, you know they're going to be out here.
I heard.
So all you have to do is get through Siskel and Ebert. Boom, you're home free. Okay. And Tim, if you can, shortly, what is your story?
I'm a photojournalist for WDAF-TV in Kansas City, Missouri.
Oh, good for you. How long have you worked there?
2 years now.
Now, would that be the CBS affiliate there?
No, that would be the NBC affiliate that just became a Fox affiliate.
We're going to have to ask you to leave, Tim. Okay, well, I hope you guys enjoy the show. If there's anything we can do to make your stay a little more comfortable, by all means, keep it to yourselves. Oh, here, we have a shirt. If you're a little chilly, you want to slip into a shirt, Tim, here you go, because you seem to be the wetter of the two. There you are. Thank you very much. You had the umbrella, yeah.
Yeah.
How long have you guys been, dating, or whatever you kids call it these days?
2 years.
2 years? Good. Plans to get married, maybe?
I don't know. Yeah.
Oh. I thought we were.
That excellent piece of police work on your part, ma'am. Siri. Ladies and gentlemen, I have here in my right hand a copy of tonight's top 10 list. Let's see. I like that Midnight Oil song, them boys down under. What's the name of that song?
Beds Are Burning.
Beds Are Burning. Yeah, those guys are good.
They were here.
Yeah, they were here. Get them back on the show, Paul.
They scared you.
I was frightened because Many of today's rock and roll musicians frighten me, as
I
you know.
I know.
How about those guys last night, Green Day?
Yeah, they were scary.
You like
they
Green
were
Day?
Good and scary.
Green Day, do you like Green Day?
Love Green Day.
Oh. Cool. Did you bring your own microphone, Tim?
I think you did.
So deal with that guy. I've never seen behavior like that anywhere in my entire life. And God bless him, we got him. All right. The category from the home office in Sioux City, Iowa, top 10 ways CBS will be different after merging with QVC. You know, that's what they're talking about now, CBS and QVC merging into one giant broadcast cable entity. Here we go, top 10 ways CBS will be different after the big merger. Number 10, you know that stopwatch on 60 Minutes? It's yours for $49.95. Number 9, many things will change, but Connie Chung will still be married to that dweeb Monty. Number 8. I'll get paid in cubic zirconias. Number 7. Once per episode of Murder, She Wrote, Jessica will look right at the camera and yell, "We got blenders for sale!" Number six, Fox executives will be able to call in and buy whatever sports CBS has left. Number five, the CBS Eye logo and the QVC Chipmunk logo will be combined into a spooky eye chipmunk creature. Number four, no matter what, we'll still be working for TV weasels. Absolutely. Number three, little number in corner of screen will go up every time Bob Barker scores. Number two. That's Megan. I like Megan. She seems like a very, very nice young woman.
She is, yeah.
Number two, during the evening news, Dan Rather sells the pants right off his ass. And the number one way, CBS will be different after merging with QVC. Goodbye, Tiffany Network. Hello, Kmart Network. There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, for my money, there are no better judges of film today than our first guests. They are the very reason we have two chairs out here, folks. Please welcome back America's sweethearts, Gene Siskel and Roger Ebert. Here they come. Kids, come on up. It's a little like being at a wedding or some kind of reception, isn't it?
Good Midwestern style.
Absolutely. Look at that face. She has a very, very, a great deal of character in her face.
Kind of a Madonna, a Renaissance Madonna.
Very, very lovely. And then the guy she's with, of course, is Tim, who absolutely can't stop talking.
The obvious question is, why is this guy who's fully employed dating college girls?
Yeah, well, you got to know. Well, there's nothing wrong with that. What do you mean?
Well, he's a lot older, isn't he?
How old are you?
18.
You know, he's one of those guys, you just want to go over there and slap him. Why don't you go over it? Go over there and slap him. Just go over there and slap him. Beat that. Yes. Go ahead, knock him silly. Drop him. Come on, drop him. Come on. All hell has broken loose. Welcome back to the show, kids. What's going on? Hey, you know, we spent the day. You were nice enough. It was 1 week ago today. The three of us toured New Jersey, the neighborhoods of New Jersey. We had a lovely day.
I think it was every viewer's fantasy. We spent 5.5 hours just with you.
Oh, God bless you. But you know what? We've done this a lot. We go to these neighborhoods, whether it's in New Jersey or Connecticut or New York, and we just go door to door talking with people. And what you find out is people are always really, really very, very nice.
We weren't really interested in the people. We were more interested in finding out about you.
Yeah? What do you mean by that?
Well, I learned that you're a very bad basketball player.
Well, there's a reason for that. I used to be okay. I was never great. I used to be okay.
You're from Indiana.
That's right.
The home of Hoosier basketball.
That's right. Hoosier madness.
You
Hoosier
must have been
hysteria.
Locked in your room by your parents like a veal. You were...
Like a veal?
Like a veal, yeah.
He was...
Slap him!
Like a veal?
No, you shot an air ball.
Yeah.
You missed a layup.
Yeah.
And I posted you up and drove around you and scored like nothing.
Yeah, but I mean...
You're in shape. You got lean for the new show, and you were a lousy hoops player.
He even held a ladder and made me climb up and clean out the gutters of that lady's house.
But, you know, the truth of it is, like I said, I used to play okay. I was never great. But in 1968, and it was like the finals of the NCAA Division II college championships, I blew out every ligament in my right knee, seriously, and still scored 40 points.
You saw that. That in a movie.
Well, why not? Hey, let's get...
What did you learn about him that you didn't know?
Very thoughtful, very philosophical. At one point he said, you know, you're born and you grow up and you have that moment when everything is going just right, and then it's all downhill from there, and then you die. I mean, we had a little talk, Dave and I, and that's what he told me.
I never said that.
You saw pictures of a beautiful high school girl, actually.
Oh, we did. We went in, and there was a lovely...
You were so philosophical at that point. I mean, it was just really touching.
But, you know, if you think about it, it's a great luxury to be able to do this. What are we taking photos for the new stamp? What is this?
And then you told me that you had a cat that was 48 years old.
My wife noticed that you have beautiful feet. We took off our clothes. We can give that away.
That's right, we did. At one point, we undressed. Tell them why. We had to...
No, I don't want to say why. Let that stay on the...
No.
We took off our clothes.
I'll say why.
No, no, don't say why.
Well, I will say why.
I want to talk about his feet.
We were searching for ticks.
Yeah.
My wife said you have tan, articulated toes.
Oh, well. You're sorry you couldn't have been here tomorrow night now, aren't you? I tell you what, we got to do a commercial, and then we'll continue whatever this is with Gene and Roger. Come on back, folks. Show tonight, Siskel and Ebert, Andrea Martin, and I'm sorry we've run out of time. The Indigo girls won't be here tonight. Oh, it's a joke! It's a joke. Sit still. Come on. Boy, she was out of here, though, wasn't she? Thank you for that vote of confidence. Let's talk about you guys a little bit. Let's explore the relationship. You spend a great deal of time together, professionally and socially, I would imagine.
Not socially?
No. But you travel to and from places.
Yeah.
Film festivals.
On the same airplane sometimes, yeah.
Do you ever like play jokes on
one
another?
I like to play jokes on
pranks.
Roger. I feed his ego, mm-hmm. and then I set him up for jokes. Like for example, we were taking a flight. He came on, and he complained that the seating was too cramped, mm-hmm. faulting the airplane, which of course would be debatable in his case. But anyway, he faulted the aircraft.
It was the foot room.
I see. Anyway, he didn't know I was on the plane, so I sent a note through the stewardess. Pretending to be from the cockpit, saying, Mr. Ebert, we in the cockpit heard about your complaints about the MD-80 aircraft, and we agree with you. We know you're an important journalist in Chicago. Feed the ego. Anything I say after that, he's going to agree with. He said, if you will keep our opinions private, the navigator didn't come in today. Mm-hmm. We have an extra seat up here in the cockpit. Please knock on the door when the seatbelt sign is removed. And you can fly with us.
All right, now let me confirm this. So far it's true, everything he's saying?
Yes, oddly enough.
So you get the note.
I got the note, and I thought it was on the level.
Right.
And I thought, gee, that was really nice. So when the light went off, I took off my seatbelt, and I went up to knock on the door. I think usually they shoot you at that point.
Well, that's what happened to me.
Federal marshals take you off the
plane. Now, my view from behind, two rows from behind, I see Roger reading the note, and I... Then I know I got. That's the line about being the respected journalist out of Chicago, you know.
But think of it. The next week we'd be ready to do our show, and we couldn't do it because I would be in jail with federal aircraft hijacking charges.
Well, this is what happened. Then I realized he's getting up, and I said, "There goes my meal ticket. Right. They're going to kill him."
Yeah.
So I, as he was
interceded,
about to knock,
you intervened,
I said, "We in the cockpit are standing right behind you."
That's good. But now, do you ever do anything to Gene?
I never really have played any practical jokes on him. His ego is so fragile that I think really he wouldn't stand up under something like that.
I sent him a note from an actor, a young actor in Cop and a Half, an autographed picture, Burt Reynolds, terrible picture. Even Burt Reynolds, I'm sure, hated the film. Norman D. Golden III, the little boy. And I sent a note to him, Dear Roger, using a child's scrawl, Dear Roger, all the kids in my class like you more than Gene.
Just think,
Norman D. We put it up on the bulletin board. He's pointing it out to everybody.
Think of all the valuable network time we're losing here to have these juvenile pranks of yours retailed at great length.
Oh, but it's way too late to be worrying about that.
Well, look
Roger.
What they already started out with.
Yeah, look at that.
How about the dialing of the phone call? That was exciting, wasn't it?
Now let me ask you about: maybe these are two separate episodes? It's something about a card game on an aircraft. Was it Gin Rummy or something?
Oh, that was very irritating. Yes, Gene and I were playing Gin Rummy on an airplane, and he inadvertently put some cards on the discard stack instead of on the meld, and then realized what he had done, mm-hmm. and wanted to pick them up again and replay the cards.
Yes, you can't do that.
You can't do that.
You can't do that.
Even when it's inadvertent, we just had.
Even when it's inadvertent,
you're playing for money.
We're playing for money. Yes.
No, you can't take it back.
No,
if you're playing for money,
you can't take it back.
A penny, a point.
And he had a little tantrum, and he threw the cards down, and they flew all over the airplane, and the stewardess.
No. You hit the tray, and the food went up. The cards went up, and guess what? He grabbed the food.
Once you take your hand off the cards, that's That's it.
Hey, speaking of money, can I buy the Letterman plate for $23.75?
Well, you have to talk to the kids. They're the proud owners of them now.
Oh.
Oh, gee.
Oh, you're
going
to
sell it? How much?
No, wait. I'm kidding.
No, seriously, there's a chance to make some scratch here.
How about 100?
Not
that's
worth
my
it,
200.
$200.
No, do you say you're buying it from him or from her?
I'm buying, I don't want the Paul plate.
No. That's all right, Paul. I'll give you $300 for that Paul plate.
$350 over here. $350.
Guys, good to see you. I'm sorry we didn't get a chance to talk about the big summer blockbusters, but maybe another time, eh?
You got it.
Roger, nice to have you
Take
with
care.
Us. Have a safe trip back to Chicago, and no quarreling, kids. We'll be right back here, ladies and gentlemen. Siskel and Ebert. Indigo Girls are here, and Andrea Martin will be out in a bit. Tomorrow on the program, Connie Chung. Wow, it's been a long time since Connie has been on the show. And Phil Collins, that'll be quite a show tomorrow night. What do you think?
Glad for the Indigo Girls.
Yeah? You're going to stay for the Indigo Girls?
I think so.
Because you can come back tomorrow night for Phil Collins, but you have to leave now.
We'll stay.
All right, they're going to stay. How about that? They're going to... I understand everything's up to date in Kansas City. Is that true?
Got about as far as they can go.
Now, you know what I wanted to do when Siskel and Ebert were here? You didn't tell me a thing about this. Over the weekend, I went to see Speed.
Oh, you saw it.
Oh, man, it's unbelievable. Yeah. This is a gripping action-adventure summertime thriller, and you didn't tell me that you're in the movie.
I had a small little
When did you do that?
Remember when I took that day off in the fall? I took
Is that right?
Yes. It was a small part. It only took a day to do it.
But you know what it was? I was so enthralled in the action of the film, and then all of a sudden, I see my friend Paul, and then I burst out laughing. It was a great little scene.
It was a serious role.
Yeah. Do you mind if we show the people the
clip?
You
have the clip?
Yeah, we have the clip.
Oh, you're kidding.
Watch this. Paul Schaefer now in the blockbuster Speed. Here we go.
Excuse me, aren't we going a little fast?
Unbelievable. Very nice.
Thank you.
Nice job.
Thank you. It's just, nice of you to do that.
We're going to do a commercial. We'll be right back with Indigo Girls, folks. Come on, band. Are you ready? Are you excited? This is it. This is why you came from Kansas City. Our next guests are a Grammy-winning duo, and they're joining our band tonight to perform a song from their enormously popular new album entitled Swamp Ophelia. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Indigo Girls. Kids, come on out.
I sit two stories above the streets. It's awful quiet here since love fell asleep. There's life down below me though. The kids are walking home from school. Some long ago when we would talk before whatever kind of puzzle you got. Just stick the right formula in. The solution for every fool. I remember the time when I came so close to you. Send me skipping my class, running from school. And I bought you that ring, cause I never was cool. what makes me think I could start clean slated. My hardest to learn was the least complicated. Objection, I'm kind of dodging the strap. Boy and girl are holding hands on the streets. I don't want to, but I think he just waits. It's more than just eye to eye. Learn the things I could never apply. I remember the time. What makes me stack? I can start playing the hardest and hardest to lose, cause the keys complicated. I'm just a mirror of myself. All the things that I do. And the next time I fall, I'm gonna have to start a song. There's a song to be something. I sit two stories above the streets. Awful quiet is since love fell asleep. There's life down below me though. The kids are walking home from school. I remember the time when I came so close to you. Sitting there skipping my class and running from school. What makes me think I could start clean slated? The hardest to learn was the least complicated. So what makes me think I could start clean slated? The hardest to learn was the least complicated.
Indigo Girls. That's a great song. Nice to see you again. How you been? Good to see you. Look, it's Megan. She's from Kansas City. That's Tim over there. We don't want him over here. He's trouble. Nice job. Did you enjoy that?
I enjoyed it.
Good for you. You all right, Tim? Okay. Folks, we're going to do a commercial. We'll be right back with Andrea Martin. Oh, you were at the show last night. Is an alumna of SCTV and recently a Tony Award winner. Currently, she is appearing in Shakespeare's The Merry Wives of Windsor right here in Central Park. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome comedian, thespian, Andrea Martin. Andrea, come on out and say hello to the floor, ladies. See you again, Andrea. Hi, how are you? It's been a long time. Thank you. Don't paralyze me there. There we go. How you doing? Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much. I actually was in this theater before doing Kate and Allie.
Oh, that's where they used to tape that Situation Comedy.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah, did you ever know which one was Kate, which one was Allie?
You know, I really did.
That's why the show went off the air after about 8 years. People just got fed up. They couldn't figure it out.
No, I did. But they paid me, and I got the show up.
Yeah, congratulations on your big Broadway. Was it your debut? And
it was my Broadway debut.
And you won a big Tony Award for
that. I did win a big Tony Award.
Nice going. That's great. You come in the first time and you get yourself an award. There you go. What could be better than that?
I don't know.
Have you won a Have you won other awards?
Do you know, one of the first awards I ever won, we've never talked about this, was a SitVig Award.
I didn't think we were going to talk about it tonight.
No, yes,
there for
I was sort of paralyzed with fear just looking at your face, you know? God help me. What next?
Why don't you go sit on the stairs then if you're going to do that?
Yeah. A SitVig Award. Oh, you know, it was a little something for a film I did called Cannibal Girls.
I didn't know that.
It was a Best Actress Award at the International Horror Film Festival.
Ooh,
yes.
Congratulations.
Yes, right. Thank you very much. Yes.
And now.
Yes.
Cannibal Girls are on tomorrow night. You want to come back for the Cannibal Girls? They'll be on tomorrow night. They're very good. The kids love them. The kids are crazy about it. They drive the kids wild, the Cannibal Girls. And you have a one-woman show that you're developing?
Yeah, I was working on
this
it right
perfect
before.
Perfect for you.
Do you think?
Oh,
a one-woman
yeah.
show, yeah.
Yeah.
I was working on it right before I came here to do Merry Wives of Windsor. It was called Andrew Martin's Work in Progress, and I haven't found a title for it yet.
That's all right.
So.
That'll come.
Yeah, you think?
Sure.
Can I try out some titles on you?
Sure.
Sure, all right. Here were the things we decided on. Well, we didn't decide on, but we went through. Open up the kennels, Kenneth. Mama's coming home tonight.
I like that. Well, that's
nude, totally nude.
Yeah.
Aged ham.
Aged ham.
Bitter party of one. The Who's Tommy. How about No Sex, Please, I'm Funny?
Yeah.
I like that.
Any of these would be good.
Sure.
Yeah. Yeah. And what kind of stuff would you do? And it would be like anecdotal, biographical?
You know, I talk about my family, I talk about my kids, I talk about my life, I do some old things. Oh, I do some old SCTV things, a few things. I do some old stand-ups. I did Connie Francis, the world's most depressing singer. You remember that? I'm losing my hearing. I lost sight in one eye. I'm sorry I can't hear you. Did you really say goodbye, Mama? And Indira Gandhi, remember from Evita? You remember?
Yeah, you have a great voice. You have a great voice.
Stand back, Rahul Pundi. Because you're gonna get what you're gonna get in me. Just a little touch of star quality. Oh, for God's sake.
But you know, you're just a tiny little thing, and you have a hugely powerful voice.
Oh, well, listen to this one, then. Ethel Merman in
Lovers
Only. Ethel Merman. Listen. Do you want to know a secret? Killing me softly with his song. Killing me softly.
Nice.
Whee! Oh, yeah.
And you're doing Shakespeare now. Man, you can do everything, can't you? When does that begin?
That, well, we're in previews right now. It begins next Thursday.
Are you nervous? Have you ever done Shakespeare anywhere
before? I've never done Shakespeare. The most nerve-wracking thing was I thought that if I would go up on a line, I wouldn't be able to
you
improvise
forgot your
in
lines,
Shakespeare.
Yeah, you
because
can just
how
cover
do you,
yourself.
You know,
yeah.
Well, you can't really do that.
No.
No. But luckily, they give out cliff notes, a sort of synopsis at the front of the theater, so at any given moment, somebody from the audience can yell
just
out.
Just scream
you know,
it right out
yeah,
at you.
You forgot my liege.
We got to do us one of them commercials you've heard so much about. We'll be right back here with Andrea Martin. Okay, we're out of time, Andrea. Thank you very much. My thanks to the Indigo Girls, Siskel and Ebert, tomorrow, Connie Chung, Phil Collins. Let's go say goodbye to the kids. Good night, everybody.
Pants. This is CBS.